So, yeah, I was just touching up my lip color because I've been up since before 7 a.m. today. It is currently almost 2 p.m. and I was at a photo shoot all morning doing makeup for them, and it was so much fun but kind of tired now. But we are also celebrating my sister's birthday later today, so I figured in between, why not film some videos? Yay! So, the first video I'm going to film today is my 2012 beauty favorites. Well, just makeup, really. I'm not gonna do the huge, like, I like this shaving cream, I like this hairspray kind of thing. I'm gonna do makeup because that's what I know and love the most. So, that's what I'm doing today. It's kind of late in the game. I know it's almost, like, February already. But, I don't know. I still wanted to film it, and this is what I thought to. So here we go. It's gonna be really random. I'm just gonna grab something and tell you why it's my favorite. So my first favorite is my favorite powder. Became this Laura Geller Balanced and Brighten, and I have it in Fair. And I got this for my birthday from my sister, the sister whose birthday we're celebrating today, which is kind of ironic. But I just love it. I love setting my makeup with it. It really does, you know, make your skin look on point. While we're on face makeup, my favorite bronzer, which I also got for my birthday, which is the end of August, just so everyone knows, so I did have a decent amount of time of 2012 to use it, was this Too Faced Chocolate Soleil bronzer in chocolate, the original one. Smells like chocolate. You can't resist smelling it every time you use it and open it. I have a review on this. I'll put that in the description box. Anything I have reviews on will be in the description box below, so check that out because I think several of these things I have reviews on. Yeah, because I just love them that much. My favorite blush is the e.l.f., well, for 2012 at least, the e.l.f. Studio Blush in Tickled Pink. You really can't tell, but I used this like there was no other blush in the world. I just attacked this one blush, and it's just that, ooh, it does have a nice dent in it. It just has that like perfect pink color for anyone, for every day, and I mean, this just became the blush that I always used, like, on those mornings that I'd wake up for classes, and I was just like, no, this isn't happening, so my go-to blush. Go-to highlighter for the year was the Revlon Colorstay Mineral Finishing Powder. This actually changed towards the end of the year, but I keep coming back to this. I've had this for a long time. It's just a really pretty sheen, really pretty natural-looking glow right there. So, really, really pretty. I love this powder. This is an amazing, amazing highlight, and I actually hear it's kind of like, ooh. I actually hear it's kind of like a mineral skin finish from MAC, but don't quote me because I don't know. My favorite face primer was L'Oreal Studio Secrets Professional Magic Perfecting Base. The thing that I hate about this is for the drugstore, this is like the most expensive for the least amount of product because you get a half fluid ounce, and you can see I love it. I just, now I don't even use this unless it's like a special event or something. That's how much I love it, and I just don't feel like replacing it. Now I'm using, like, the Revlon Photo Ready one and my Rimmel, but, this is just the most amazing drugstore, primer that you can find. It feels amazing, mattifies your skin, keeps everything on all day, but again, you get half fluid ounce and it's, like, 15 bucks, so kind of stinks for the drugstore. Favorite concealers, I have two. My favorite for like acne and lines and just anything you gotta conceal on your face has been the MAC Studio Finish Concealer. It has an SPF of 35, which is like amazing. That's like the most SPF I've heard of in a makeup product, but there's a nice little dent. So I've been loving this for just anywhere on my face I need it. And then my favorite, concealer for the under eyes is the Instant Age Rewind for dark circles. I know now there's a new one that's in white packaging. If you're looking for this, don't get that one. That one, like, I thought, I was like, oh, new packaging. If you read it, that one is for, like, dark spots on your face and concealing your face, whereas this one is strictly dark circles. I mean, you could do whatever you want, but this one is for the dark circles. It's a treatment concealer specifically for under here. However, I have used this around my nose and stuff, and I really like how it looks there as well, but anyways, this is like an amazing concealer for under the eyes. Amazing. And to set those beautiful looking under eye areas is this Benefit Powderflash. I got this around my birthday. It wasn't for my birthday, but it's just a like pink tinted shimmery under eye concealer setting powder, and it's amazing. It makes it so any concealer you put under there does not crease at all, and it also helps with the concealing process since pinks help with blue kind of veins. So awesome. This NYX Nude Matte Shadow in Tryst something like that, T-R-Y-S-T. This has been my go-to eyebrow powder. I had been using pencils early in the year, but I wanted to try a powder that could be my go-to powder just for eyebrows. I don't use this as eyeshadow, and it's working pretty good. I like how it comes out, and to do my whole brows, then I use this disposable wand, which I need a new one because it's getting really gross, but I brush it out, blend it in, and then I use this Great Lash Clear Mascara, go away hair, by Maybelline to set them, and so my eyebrows aren't like flying all over the place. But that's been my eyebrow routine for months and months, and I'm really enjoying it. Favorite eyeliners. I didn't really have favorite eyeliners. Back and forth between a lot of them. So, but I chose for this video these two NYX ones. There's Golden Bronze and Pretty Violet, and I got these just because I wanted really cool colors. And I just, these things are really comparable to Urban Decay 24/7 liners. Oh my goodness! The purple took two swipes, but that copper took one swipe. Amazing, amazing pigmentation. So smooth and easy to apply, and they're just fun. When you want a little color, you don't want it in your eyeshadow, you don't want it in your lips, add some colored liner. It's really fun. Favorite eyeshadows, my favorite part. Eyeshadow is my absolute favorite part of makeup application, just because you can do so much with it. So, favorite single eyeshadows would be these Wet n Wild Color Icon Shadows. This is, like, another product I have reviews on. However, I've already mentioned, like, several others I do as well, so check that description box. But I have these in Brulee and Nutty. I really wanted the one in Penny, because I heard it's a dupe for something with pink in it, for MAC. I don't know, some pink name. But these are what they look like. Brulee is an awesome, awesome all-over matte color. And then Nutty is, like, just amazing. I love these shadows. Except, see how much Nutty is broken? Don't travel with these. I guess these just aren't travel-friendly. But for, like, a buck each. So if anyone finds Penny still, let me know where you find it, because I've looked everywhere and must be discontinued, which makes me sad because I didn't get my hands on it, but super pigmented and awesome. Also from Wet n Wild, my favorite trio is Walking on Eggshells. I have yet to try their 8 eyeshadow palettes. I really want to do that this year. I felt like I didn't need to, but just Wet n Wild, I mean, amazing pigmentation for like no money at all. Okay, this is $3, so $1 an eyeshadow. These are amazing. Okay? Look at that. Just, you can't beat it. I mean, and the eyelid color, this bottom one, in Walking on Eggshells Trio, kind of a dupe for Naked Lunch by MAC, because I have that one. So, pretty, pretty awesome. And then my favorite palettes, which I had so much fun with, were the Naked 2 by Urban Decay, which I got for my birthday, and let me try not to blind you. But there is, whoa, I'm blending you anyway, and there goes the brush. But, Naked 2 palette, I've been loving it. I use the Naked 2, like, 99% of the time I wore makeup throughout the whole fall semester. It was just amazing to go to. And then Lorac Pro palette, which I love that you can bend back like this. You got 8 mattes and 8 shimmers, and they all go together, and perfect, perfect. I got sent this from an amazing, amazing subscriber. I did a whole video on it, because she was only supposed to send me color tattoos that I couldn't find. One. And she sent me all 4, and then she sent me this, and I'm just like, people love me this much? So, again, thank you very much. This has been a well-loved palette. I love my neutrals, so these palettes have been go-to. I totally forgot! I'm not going in order, see? My favorite eyeshadow primer is still the Urban Decay eyeshadow primer potion, and this is a mini baby one, but I love that they changed the packaging because now you get every last ounce of it, but my favorite. I also use it in my makeup kit. It's just my go-to, works on everybody and is amazing, and I love it. And then my favorite eyeshadow base, another item from my subscriber, became the limited edition Barely Beige. Now I hear they have another nude one, which is actually a dupe for, I'm forgetting names today, what's the one by MAC? It's not Painterly, it's the other popular one. Bare Study. It's apparently a dupe for that, but, I don't know. Oh, wow. Color tattoo actually looks pretty similar to that Walking on Eggshells shadow, but I love that for a base. It's the only cream shadow that literally does not crease on me. The only one. Favorite mascaras? Where did it go? Okay, well, I'll just tell you, because I don't know where it went. No, I'm sad. Oh, no, I found it. Okay. A little disorganized. My favorite volumizing is the CoverGirl Lash Blast Volume, the original one. And my favorite lengthening is the e.l.f. Mineral Infused Mascara. Put these two together and you're in heaven. I did a video on this all about just putting these mascaras together because that's how amazing it is. So please go check that out. Favorite lip balm, this should be mentioned, are my EOS lip balms. I basically just about used my whole Strawberry Sorbet one. It's like a little nub left. And then this is, was from the limited edition Alice in Wonderland collection. It's the vanilla one. And I love it. Favorite lipsticks, which aren't really, they're not lipsticks, but I kind of consider them because they're so, did this melt? Because they're so, pigmented, but it's, I swear to God, this, like, melted. The Revlon Lip Butters. This is Creme Brulee, and I swear it wasn't, like, that used or in that position, but I feel like it melted. But there's Creme Brulee. Did a review on these. They're, like, the most amazing, awesome products for your lips at the drugstore. Peach Parfait, which is my least favorite because it has, like, chunky glitter in it. And then Raspberry Pie, which is my favorite, because it's just an amazing color. But I would consider them lipsticks just because they're so opaque and they're awesome. So check those out for sure. I think this is my last category. No, it's not. I lied. Okay, this is my second to last. Lip glosses. I'm kind of just throwing some out there because, again, like, I use different ones on different days, so I didn't really have a favorite. I enjoy these Bare Minerals ones. This one's a new one. This one I've had. This one was a new one. This is Fruit Cocktail. I also got 2 new NYX Mega Shine lip glosses. I have a couple others, but these are new. This is Nude Peach and Cosmo, so those are fun. Some people hate the smell. I actually like it. And then these Revlon Color Burst lip glosses. A lot of people like the smaller ones, the more traditional size lip glosses. I actually like these. I haven't tried the others, but oh no! My swatches are getting on my black pants. I haven't tried the others, but I really like these. People complain that they're sticky. I don't know. So this is Strawberry, and look at that color. It's just amazing. And then this probably is my favorite. Bellini. This is just the absolute perfect lip gloss. It's just that perfect, like, center, I don't know what you call it, but, like, when you put it in the center just to make your lips pop, it's just perfect. Favorite eyelash curler will always be my e.l.f. $1 eyelash curler. It's just amazing. I love the bouncing back. I'm probably going to break it if I keep doing that, but it's just the most amazing eyelash curler I've ever tried. Favorite brushes would be all of these. They're kind of messy and disorganized right now because one is clean, one's dirty. But my Sigma Mrs. Bunny Essential Brushes, just amazing. My Sigma F80 for foundation. This one's e.l.f. Small Stipple Brush. This is great for a cream blush or highlight. My Sephora Stipple Brush, which I've had for years and years. This was my most expensive brush back in the day. And I just checked recently, this went down, like, by half. And I'm like, why? But anyways, I was so happy when I got this. The e.l.f. Flawless Concealer Brush, also have a review on that, and it's pretty, pretty good. And then more Sigma Bunny Brushes. So, that wraps it up. I'm done. That's it. It's kind of a long video, I know, but I just wanted to get through everything, and I hope you enjoyed this, and let me know what your favorite beauty or makeup items of 2012 were. Hopefully we have some of the same, because these are a lot of commonly used products, so I hope that you kind of try what you want from this whole experience, this whole video, and let me know what works and what doesn't. I hope you enjoyed this, and I'll catch you in the next one. Bye!